Wiley peccaries roam the forest in herds of 20 to 300 individuals. Anecdotal reports of groups of 2,000 individuals have even been recorded. I'm your host, Romy Casagnino, and I'm a conservation scientist, writer, and photographer. Every episode, we'll be introducing you to new animals caught on camera traps around the world.
And we are getting some footage from Bonga Bay.
These are some of the extents we take to get our SD card.
Don't forget to subscribe to Monga Bay to get notifications about our latest videos. Wiley peccaries are known as the pigs of the jungle. They are recognized by their brown or black fur with a distinctive white patch or lip around the snout. They live in Central and South America and prefer dense, humid tropical forests, but they can also be found in dry savannas and tropical dry forests. Wiley peccaries are diurnal, but tend to be most active in the early mornings and late afternoons. As they live in large groups, they need ways to stay together and locate other members of the herd when traveling. To do that, they use noise and smell. Peccaries are very vocal. They clatter their teeth, grunt, and if there's a potential threat, they bark. They also use scent. Peccaries have a scent gland on their backs that allow them to bond and recognize each other. They also use this scent to mark its territory by rubbing against trees and rocks. And if you're walking through the forest, you can usually tell when a herd is nearby because of their powerful smell. Researchers say that the combined sensory experience of noise and scent they produce can sometimes stretch to a length of nearly 2 football fields. Due to the large number of wiley peccaries in a herd, they have to travel over a large range of land to find food. That is why they need big home ranges, anywhere from 19 to 200 square kilometers for a single herd. If necessary, large herds will split into smaller subgroups to forage in different areas. Wiley peccaries are omnivorous. They eat everything they can find, from snakes and insects to leaves and fruit, but they will always prefer to get fruits over anything else. The wiley peccary is a classic example of an ecological engineer. First, they create and maintain wallows, which create new habitats for other species. Second, as they travel over large areas, they spread seeds throughout the landscape. And then, with their trampling, they break the crust of the soil and help plant the seeds. And third, they also mulch the soil surface with trampled vegetation, fertilizing the landscape. The wiley peccary doesn't have a specific breeding season, and the majority of births are twins, although sometimes a single or triplets are born. Wiley peccaries are listed as vulnerable by the IUCN. Their two main threats are hunting and deforestation. This species is not only hunted for bushmeat, but also by farmers due to damage they cause to maize plantations. On the other hand, the continued loss of habitat due to deforestation has made them a highly threatened species in some countries. For example, in some Central American countries, populations have already become locally extinct. That is why it's important to have effective conservation measures to prevent overexploitation and ensure habitat protection, as they require large areas of forest to survive. In the next episode, we'll be meeting an animal that gets its name from a group of monks that have a distinctive call or hood. Tell us in the comments if you know what animal it is. See you next time.
Monga Bay.